He had to wait a long time. Here at the Hard Rock of Atlantic City, the end comes at 2 minutes, 45 seconds of round number 7. The winner, by knockout victory, still undefeated, and now the new unified light heavyweight champion of the world, Eleider Alvarez.
As I said earlier, he has a fantastic personality. He is very entertaining in conversations. So it's fun to see Eleider Alvarez suddenly rise to the top with his spectacular performance there in the 7th round against Sergey Kovalev. Kovalev landed 18 punches more, threw 88 punches more. Alvarez landed at a slightly higher connect percentage. He was the counterpuncher through much of the fight. But when he saw his opportunity, and as Roy Jones said, Kovalev tired just a little bit coming into that round. And Alvarez, with his awareness as a former Colombian Olympian, understood what to do as he took over with power shots. They both wind up landing 33% of their power shots, but Eleider Alvarez's 7th round barrage was most meaningful. And here's Max Kellerman with a new light heavyweight champion.
Congratulations, champ. You've waited a long time for your title shot. What are you feeling right now?
Bueno, no sé ni cómo escribir cómo me siento.
I just can't even describe how I feel.
Primero que todo quiero agradecerle a Dios.
First of all, I want to thank God.
A todo mi grupo de trabajo, mi entrenador Mark Ramsey.
All my team, Mark Ramsey, my trainer.
Mi manager Stefan Lepin. El grupo Yvonne Michel.
My manager, somebody be Yvonne Michel.
A la gente de Quebec, Canadá, que me dio su apoyo siempre.
And all the public from Quebec, Canada, that always supported me.
A Colombia, a mi familia en Colombia, a mis amigos en Montreal, mis amigos en Colombia.
And to Colombia, all my family in Colombia, my friends in Montreal, my family in Montreal.
No tengo, si empiezo a mencionar la gente, no termino hoy.
You know, if I started to mention each one individually, I just wouldn't have time to finish today.
You started off the fight really well, outboxing Kovalev, in my opinion, early. But then in the 4th round, he started to unload on you. It seemed to be a pivotal moment in the fight. Could you take his punches and come back or not? What were you thinking in that 4th round?
Pues, quería demostrarle que soy fuerte, que tengo un buen mentón, y que estoy hecho para grandes cosas.
I wanted to show him that I am strong, that I have a good chin, and that I'm ready for big things.
Do you feel that he was discouraged at all? Because after unloading those big power shots, you were still there, still boxing with him, still exchanging with him.
Bueno, pienso que un poco mermó un poco. Sus golpes ya no eran los mismos letales que el comienzo de la pelea. Entonces, por eso, la táctica de nosotros como entrenador fue trabajarlo adentro.
You know, we slowed him a bit, and I felt that his punches weren't as hard as they were at the beginning of the fight, and part of the tactics was to be able to work him on the inside.
But it's one thing to wear a guy down and from an accumulation of punches, knock him out. This was essentially a one-punch knockout, a right hand that basically ended the fight. You talked about the surgery you had on your right hand at the end of your amateur career and how you can only punch with two knuckles now as a pro. Was that a two-knuckle punch or a four-knuckle punch?
De dos nudillos, como te dije, me acostumbré a pegar con solamente dos nudillos. Y así fue, porque practicamos ese golpe durante todo el campo de entrenamiento y salía muy bien.
That was a two-punch knockout, you know, and that's what happened. I fought like that through my career. And we practiced that punch during training camp, and that's how it went.
But where did the power come from again suddenly? You're a power puncher as an amateur, but not as a pro. You fought a lot of good fighters as a pro, and I haven't seen that kind of power. Where did that come from tonight?
Por eso, siempre practico ese golpe. Y pensábamos que era una de las armas letales que podíamos hacer con Kovalev después del quinto o sexto asalto. Y así fue, salió bien.
I always practiced that punch, as I said, in training, and it felt like it was something that we can do, and it would be after the 5th, the 6th, 7th round, more or less.
Quickly, Dmitry Bivol fought on the co-feature. He is an elite light heavyweight. What do you think about a fight with Bivol?
Bueno, yo estoy preparado para pelear con el que sea. Estoy en hace 5 años estoy en los mejores 135 libras del mundo. No me llegó la oportunidad, me llegó ahora y estoy listo para enfrentar el que sea.
I'm ready for the best in the world. I'm ready for the best in the division. I've been waiting for 5 years for the best. I am amongst the best at 175. Whoever comes, I'm ready.
Thanks, champ, and congratulations. Jim.
Roy Jones, we're going to take a look back at all 3 knockdowns. Did Kovalev ever recover from that punch?
Away from him, there was nothing he could do that totally took all the fight out of him.
And there's the second knockdown. As Eleider Alvarez, reputed to be more a boxer than a puncher, suddenly in the 7th round became a light heavyweight Felix Trinidad.
He was a very smart guy, Jim. He took his time. He knew that Kovalev had expended a lot of punches in that 4th round. That's something that's hard for Kovalev to recover from. So by Kovalev not recovering, that messed up everything.
Official scores in the fight at the moment of the knockout, 58-56 Kovalev. 59-55 Kovalev, 59-55 Kovalev, and that's the moment at which Alvarez sprung the upset assault. And we get a look now at Sergey Kovalev in his dressing room amid the disappointment, the desolation of knowing that his reign atop the light heavyweight division has suddenly come to a halt unexpectedly.